Greetings and welcome, really.
I didn't mean to kill you.
You just destroyed so much stuff.
Oh my god.
I was carrying obscene amounts of resources because I was building loads of stuff.
Did you not have armor on?
I had a full inventory. And yeah, I did have armor, but you got good bullets. Goodness. You jerk.
I used 3 rounds.
You jerk. This is why Shen is like, no friends. No friends with Shen.
I did not mean
all
to do that.
All my stuff is gone.
Luigi is beside himself with grief. He can't believe that he killed Mario.
Welcome, everyone, to Factorio Beginner's Guide and how to lose friends. Right, I need to get all my stuff. Shen, explain what we're going to be doing today whilst I re-equip myself.
Okay, it's a good thing we have a lot of things in our factory and boxes. So today we're going to be going over last time how we had stone coming in, building stone bricks and stone walls. We've expanded our base using those stone walls. We have stone itself in some boxes, and the brick we're going to be using right now to get something that we've wanted for a long time, and that's electric furnaces. Oh boy, do we need some electric furnaces.
Indeed, we do.
We made room for them ever since day one. We knew we were going to get electric furnaces at some point. So everywhere we used furnaces, we always left some spare room because electric furnaces are, it's a 3x3 tile, right? It's just a little bit bigger than the 2x2 normal furnaces. So we're going to build some electric furnaces today, and then we're going to actually throw them down in our factory and talk to you about the advantages, disadvantages, stuff like that. And then if we have time left, I think we're going to start doing some robot automation.
Yes.
You think we have time for that?
Possibly. Depends on how distracted we get with any other problems that creep up.
I promise not to hit C anymore.
No, it's okay. But no, I mean, with laying down extra oil, also possibility of maybe cleaning up some biter bases, because they are starting to be a little bit of an annoyance here and there. It depends largely on where we go to set up the next oil expansion. We've got two possible areas near Iron Ton that would be good to just set up a pipe out. It won't be particularly well defended, but generally it won't need to be. Things usually won't just go for pipes. They'll try and go for a source of pollution. And a pipe by itself isn't making any impact really on that.
We ran out of oil, didn't we?
Ugh. Yes.
So we'll have to remedy that.
We've got a lot of ammo. This is another reason why having lots of automation on things like ammo is useful, because you never know when a wild Shen will come around and murder you.
Yeah, it's so easy to just press C and kill your friends. I don't recommend it, but it's good for a laugh.
He's lying about that, by the way. Lying about that. He absolutely recommends it.
Good laugh. So in the meantime, I'm going to use these wonderful assembly machine 2s. And we're going to get started on some electric furnace production. Oh, baby. Oh, baby.
Grab some rail. Right, I'm just getting my hot bar full of a couple of handy items. You may notice that my hot bar has got blue behind the images of the items. That's because I've filtered my hotbar only to include that item in that spot, so nothing else can occupy that spot on my hotbar. So it also acts as a good way to let me know what I'm missing as I'm refilling my inventory, because anything that I filtered is clearly something that I want to have quite a lot of, or have easy access to, I suppose is another way of putting it.
So this recipe for electric furnace is 15 steel plates, 5 advanced circuits, that's the red ones, and 10 stone brick. And it takes 5 seconds to make one furnace. So this is not a small recipe at all. It's a huge recipe. Wow. How many of these factories do you think we need? I just threw down 3. Maybe we go for 4 or something. I don't know.
4 or 5, because if you got 5, then you're producing 1 factory every second, so...
Oh, so goodness. Nice, do we need a factory a second?
Oh, absolutely. We are going to be expanding. Well, eventually, maybe. We don't really need it, but why not? That's the way I'm going to operate with this.
What is the name of this planet we're on anyway? Because we need to make it great again.
That's okay. I have decided that this planet is called Avakis. There may or may not be spice under the sand and giant worms.
Well, I think I could do without the worms, to be honest.
Okay. We can go without the worms, though.
I have no boxes. Well, I can make a box. Oh, I do have boxes. I'm a dummy.
Now, we'd already, I think as Shen mentioned, we'd already laid the tracks, as it were. We'd used the bypass for stone bricks. We'd brought up the advanced circuits, and we already had steel. Now, there is a reason why we've got this particular setup here. Each factory requires 10 bricks, 5 red circuits, and 15 steel. So as steel was the largest requirement, we let that have a whole belt to itself. And in total, each belt, the same amount of resources is needed from each belt. That is 15 resources for each factory. Unfortunately, down here, due to our lack of bricks, we are really starting to run out. Now, that means
we do
that
have extra stone.
Yeah, we do have extra stone.
We could just take some of the stone back up.
Yes, I think we possibly should. So what we'll do is I'm going
reverse
to
the switch.
This.
Reverse the flow.
Yeah, it's more or less.
Do it. Do it.
Donk.
We're gonna turn these belt, these arms around. Look at that.
Donk.
Oh,
there we are.
You've reversed the flow, Aavak. What have you done?
And some more stone just came down from Purple Quarry. There is still stone being mined at Purple Quarry. It's just not very
just
much.
Not
I think
much.
There's one or two miners working down there at the moment. We are
but
going to have to
designed
move
this
around.
We designed this with grand plans. So we're not gonna settle for however many are in here, right? How many are in here?
16. That's actually not bad.
We're not gonna settle for 16. We need more. And that means we need more bricks.
Yes.
I'm gonna grab some bricks from a box.
I'm gonna grab some of those furnaces and I'm gonna go over and start setting some of them up. I think
sounds
this
like
is
a grand
plan. Also, I'm gonna grab some walls to add back onto my hopper. That may or may
I'm
not
so
have
sorry.
Been emptied.
I'm so sorry. Will whales ever forgive me?
Probably. We're fairly nice people, honestly. Don't hold grudges
very
long.
Oh, good. I love that you can have a factory on the ground and it takes up 3x3 tiles. But
right.
You can also have a factory on a belt and it's like this tiny little cute thing.
It's flat packed from IKEA.
I was thinking maybe they're inflatable, you know?
Yeah.
Or maybe it's like those sponge dinosaurs. You just add water and all of a sudden they get big.
Sponge dinosaurs, fantastic.
You haven't seen those? Oh, they were
no,
big
actually.
When I was a kid.
Right. Okay. Now, the way that these factories go down, and this is why Shen, right at the beginning, set up the extra space here that you can see.
Wait for me, I'm coming. Okay.
I'm just pulling up the factories first. Sorry, the smelters first. So you got plenty of time. There we go. Now, we're also not going to need any more fuel. We only
Isn't that
need...
nice?
Yes. That means that we can actually start cutting back on all of the squirrely fuel lines that we've got going everywhere.
Well, we still need fuel for the trains. Unfortunately, trains
yes.
never go electric. That was
no.
something we talked about. Wouldn't it be nice if they went electric at the highest tech level?
That would actually be pretty awesome, in my opinion, yeah.
Okay, yeah, so you're taking up the factories.
Mm-hmm.
And those were all 2x2, right? Those are steel furnaces. They're the same size as the starting stone furnaces.
That's right. Now, the electric furnaces are much the same as factories. 3x3s. So you need an extra 5 tiles in total of room to place them down. And they do take up quite a lot of room. It's a lot harder to move around them, unfortunately. It's just one of the things that we'll have to live with here. We also needed to remove one of the belts to allow it to connect up properly. Oh, what are we being attacked by? Is it something serious? No, it's
fine. Gun's got it.
But we now have... Well, actually, that being said, we can't quite get the power to reach the other side. That is a shame.
I know, and then that... It's one of the weird things about how they have small power poles, then they have mediums, and then the large ones have, like, no area at all. They're meant for, like, long distance rather than a big range. We could use a, what is it called? A sub, what I think it's called?
The...
Substation.
Substation.
But the problem with that is they're a 2x2, and they take up a lot of steel and circuits. I don't really want to waste steel and circuits on an electric substation, so I think it's okay just to use one of the mediums for the middle. Because the middle is going to operate all the arms that put it onto the central belt from both sides. Right?
Yep. Actually, we can use smalls in the middle if we want to.
Oh, heathen.
I know. Well, I've got them in my inventory because I just pulled them up. It'll work. It'll be okay. Don't worry. There we go. Right, so all of that is doing its job. Now, the thing with electric furnaces... They do consume a fair bit of power. That's the trade-off. You're not using fuel, but you're using power. So in a way, you still are using fuel unless you're entirely based on solar. You know, but I've already covered that previously, that if you're using solar, that's great. But most places still have a steam backup or just never move away from steam because it's so efficient at what it does. So you're probably still burning some fuel to run them. They cause a... very, very slight amount of pollution. If we have a look at a steel smelter, that's producing 3.6 pollution. The electric smelter is producing 0.9 pollution. So very, very slight. Same crafting speed on it though, so it smelts about the same speed. But if we look at it, we've got two module slots. Now, later on, once we're producing modules, as I've mentioned, we're going to be able to use them to influence any factory, so we can make the factory more efficient. That means it produces more from the same amount of inputs, or you can make them faster, so that would in effect increase the crafting speed or reduce the amount of energy it requires, or I believe there may be one for reducing pollution, but that may have actually been taken away. Regardless though, they all have a setback, so you might increase speed, but you'll do so at a cost of extra power. You might reduce or might add more production, but you'd cause more pollution as a trade-off. The trade-offs are always more. You're always paying more than you're getting out. If you manage to make it work twice as fast, you'd be paying more than twice as much energy, and so on and so forth. But once you've... like expanded out your factory, that might be the best option you have to just keep the factory's throughput expanding. Is that about right, Shen?
Yeah, definitely. He makes a good point that the modules have trade-offs. It's never just a positive. There's always a drawback.
Yep.
And always. It's something to keep in mind that you may not want to put modules in everything in your factory. Or if you do, try to balance them out so that you don't have a sudden spike in energy consumption, which is very easy to do. If you suddenly put down modules all over the place and they require more energy, you could triple your energy consumption overnight, and it could really cripple your factory because a lot of your stuff would just turn off or go super slow. So just be a little cautious if you're going to be using modules. But just throwing down some electric smelters is probably not going to affect your factory too much. And it is definitely the first step towards modernizing the factory.
Electric smelters by themselves, without any modules at all, improve your factory. You'll use more power, but you will produce significantly less pollution, like a lot less pollution. Again, it's from 3.6 to 0.9. That is a great, great big drop. And if we replace all of our smelters, all of these smelters, then that is going to have a massive impact on the amount of pollution that our main part of our factory, Awesome Source City, is producing. And it will affect how aggressive the biters are being.
Oh, right. Man, our incoming copper is super low.
Yeah, I was just noticing that. I love it when the trains pass. That's awesome.
It's not a huge problem right now because we do have this buffer area. So we have 6 chests full of copper that are constantly just filling our main bus. But it is definitely noticeably slow here at the smelting area.
Yeah, we have got a large copper deposit just down to the south. We've also got some across to the east as well as just several different deposits to the west, including ones just south of I-Loop.
Yeah. Just a matter of hooking them up, really. But
yeah.
Just gotta keep an eye on it. Check out your belts and see now and then. Oh, it's like, is this something low? Well, and maybe I should go attach that before I do something else. You know.
Yeah. Absolutely. Right. Okay. So next up on our list of things to do, now that we've got some of the smelters being replaced, let's go ahead and see how many more have been built at this stage.
While we're
on the way there. I was just about to mention that we, off camera, as I've mentioned previously, we tend
we
to research
things.
We
never do anything off camera. No, nothing at all. No.
We tend to research anything that is a repeatable technology. In this case, we were researching 2 technologies, one of which we've finished researching, and that is logistic robot cargo size. Now, normally a logistic robot can carry 1 item as it moves from location to location. But as you increase the cargo size, it can carry more. And that's all it does. It just improves the efficiency of that one trip. In tandem with that, we've got logistic robot speed, which reduces the time it takes to get from A to B. So you're improving the efficiency in 2 different areas. And in fact, we might want to continue on that. There are actually several different technologies that unlock as we go along. But we'll just keep our research ticking along there. Shen. I had candy to put in the research thing, and you blew me up.
Candy. Cotton candy.
You scallywag.
Well, your dentist will approve.
Yes, actually. Right. Okay, so how many have we got down here? We've got 43. That's actually pretty good.
Yeah. I mean, we could throw them down all day, but
yeah, that would be a little bit boring.
I think we've already shown off how they work, how they fit into the slots. Instead of 2x2, you have 3x3. Just move your inserters around a little bit and you're good to go. Take out the fuel lines, as Aavak said, you don't need the fuel lines anymore.
Yep.
But how about we take a look at how we do robot production? How about we start on that?
Indeed. Right. Now, for robot production, just let me get this out of the way. You can't just make robots and throw them off into the sky and have them do their stuff. I mean, you can, but they'll only do it for a very short time, and then they'll run out of power, and then they'll just be kind of really sad. You are going to want to build roboports. These are expensive, very expensive constructs. As you can see, 45 steel, 45 iron gears, but 45 advanced circuits. That's the real expensive part. Thankfully, our factory is producing them in quite large amounts, so it won't be too much of a problem for us. And that's part of the reason why we set up such a large production of those advanced circuits right at the beginning. Now, this requires all of them in equal amounts, so there's no ideal one to split the lines on, unfortunately. But we should probably look to get that set up first, I would say, because we are ultimately going to need them to have any realistic use out of our robots. Because if the robot port, think of this as the air traffic control of robots. It tells the robots where they can go, what needs to be done when they get there. It's also a place where the robots can come back and resupply and refuel. So you do need these.
They resupply and they recharge their batteries. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So for this, we're going to need steel, iron gears, and advanced circuits, all of which we have in abundance. In fact, 2 of which we're already bringing up along this line, which is quite useful.
Oh, that's
for
just
us.
Too convenient, Abba.
I know.
Are you saying we can just pick and choose off this line? I think that's a good plan.
Yeah. We'll bring up iron then from this little place down here.
Do the gear production here by the main bus and do the roboport production back here.
Yeah, I think that would be fine. What we can do is we'll have the red circuits and the steel both merge onto one line. One of them has to have them merging, unfortunately. That being said,
we could just have them on separate lines.
Yeah, because we're never really going to need that many roboports. You really won't. One factory making robopods will make all the robopods you'll ever need.
Yep.
So yeah, that's a very good point.
For a lot of things in the base, like we're making regular engines, we're making red belts, we're making railroad tracks. They're just things that you're never going to need like massive, massive quantities, or in case of the red belts, they're produced super quickly, so who cares?
Yep.
For a lot of those things, one blue factory or one yellow factory, which is the level 3, those factories are probably good enough. In fact, even here for the electric furnaces, I don't think we're going to need 4 factories in the long term. But for now, we did it so that we could just update our current production with as many of these electric furnaces as possible. So because we were using these in large quantities at one time,
yeah,
we made a lot of factories to produce them. But I think we can just lower this to one factory at some point.
I'm just
okay,
going to
so I'll bring up some steel. Well, not steel, what's it called? Iron.
Yeah.
Iron.
So we are going to want that down here. There we are. And because I'm going to be annoyed if I don't set this up properly and have all of the power poles in line.
Don't be annoyed.
We'll do that. There we go. Right, now, how many gears do we need and how often? One of these will be made every 15 seconds, and gears are made one gear every 0.5, so we'll be able to make 30 gears every 15 seconds. Is near enough what we want for this, so we only actually need one, but we can have two.
He said two.
We make one gear every 0.5 seconds. So every second we make two. There we go. And that is all we really need. I'll just bring that across for convenience.
Look, Aavak, I got you some gears for your birthday. Do you like my gears?
I do. They are the most perfect gears that I have ever seen.
I'm going to add a second long inserter because they are slow.
Ah, good point. The long
actually,
inserters...
instead of a second long inserter, I'm going to turn the belt and put a blue.
Ah, a very good point. Very good point indeed. Right, and with that, we can have a single chest right about there.
So and what I'm looking at now is
we're
I have
never
going
to need this many, so I'm just going to restrict this to only 2 slots. I've no idea how much.
I think one slot would be fine. They stack in stacks of 50, don't they?
Well, if that is the case, then yeah, we'll only ever need one. They will be used up because every time you want to expand the area that your robots can operate in, you're going to need another roboport. And if, in the worst case scenario, one gets blown up, you may have the logistic coverage for your construction robots to come along and replace it. Now that's another thing they'll do. They won't just repair damaged buildings. If a building gets blown up and it's within the area where construction robots are still able to work, because obviously if it's on its own, then no construction robots can get there because they no longer have coverage. But if, for example, 2 roboports slightly overlapped and one blew up, the other one would dispatch robots to rebuild it. And that is actually a really, really nice quality of construction robots. And there we go. We've got some.
There's one small caveat, though, as far as the rebuilding. It'll show as purple on your map, meaning this is rebuildable and your robots will attempt to do it if possible. However, that will go away. That doesn't last forever.
Yes.
It's on a time limit. So if your robots are unable to do the rebuilding in a certain amount of time, then that rebuilding order will be deleted.
Yes. It is a fairly generous time limit, though, so you don't need to rush and worry about that. It will back... I can't put an exact number on it, but it's a good couple of minutes that you have. It's not like you've got 60 seconds or anything like that. It might even be 5 minutes. I'm not entirely sure on that one, though. But it is generous, and it's usually more than enough. Now,
okay, so we have our ports. What about the frames?
Now that's the next section. As I mentioned before, the internals will dictate the nature of the robot. So if you want to make a construction robot, you take a flying robot frame and 2 electronic circuits and you get a construction robot. If you want a logistics robot, you use 2 advanced circuits. But the frame itself, here we are. Now this requires something that we're not already making. We need 3 electronic circuits. We're making those. Well, we tend to make those on demand because they're so simple right. to make. We've got steel. That's on the main bus. We've got batteries. We are making those. Now, with the batteries, it's worth noting that the plan that we had a little while ago is that as we're building the batteries down on the south side of the bus, we'll always have things that need batteries be built down here within reason. I have got the solar panels being built up on the north side. It's just a little line moving up there. I might even move that down at some point. I don't know. But yep, for now, it's easy enough. So we'll probably be building the robot frames down here somewhere, down the south side. We will want to leave quite a lot of room for this for expansion, because you may find later on that you want a lot of robots, like hundreds of robots, and you'll need to be replacing ones that have been damaged, so on and so forth. But we've got most of the things that we need. The one thing that we don't, however...
I brought you some batteries.
Electric engines. Now, we have been building engines previously. In fact, we've got a little automated area off to the side. But this is very simple. Electric engines just require steel and iron for all intents and purposes. Iron gets turned into pipes and gear wheels easily enough. But the electric engine requires one resource that we haven't made at all, and that is lubricant. Do you want to tell us a little bit about lubricant, Shen?
Sure. It's very simple, and you pretty much only need it for two things. Mm-hmm. You need it for electric engines, and you need it for blue, belts. Blue belts and blue belt objects. Mm-hmm. So we haven't really reached blue belts yet, so we haven't needed lubricant at all. Mm-hmm. But now that we do need it, we can actually make some. And it's super easy to make. It takes one heavy oil, and it makes lubricant. Done. Yep. It's a liquid that goes through pipes just like water or oil.
Now, what would be the best way, do you think, for us to do that? Should we pipe up the heavy oil and then make the lubricant up here? Or perhaps have a little area maybe over here, much like we did with, like, maybe just have lubricant being made here and have some tanks or something like that?
Definitely. I like that idea, because this area up here north of the wall is where we're using our factory liquids. So this is, what is this called? Sulfuric acid. This is our first factory liquid. The next one's going to be lubricant, and we'll use that for, like I said, blue belts and also for electric engines. And then down below the wall, south of the wall, we have our industrial liquids. So we have our heavy oil, our light oil, and storage tanks for the petroleum gas. So this is our industrial area, and then it's like completely separated from our factory area. It's just like an aesthetics thing. And our crude oil down here as well.
One issue,
we are so low on crude.
Very low.
I know, we need more crude. Need crude. I mean, we can start the lubricant now. It should be okay to get started, but we need crude. Like, if I check the crude line here,
yes, we do.
It's empty.
We absolutely do. Alas, I was making Derek's. Some time ago.
Some crazy person came in here and shot Aavak.
You're not saving your own factory these days.
I didn't get a good sight of who it was. I saw he was wearing a hood. And he left in a black Escalade.
A black Escalade? Wow, okay. Yes. If you see this madman, don't approach. They're armed with...
They're dangerous, yes.
I think an assault rifle. I didn't get a good look. I was dead.
It says submachine gun. I don't really know what kind it is.
Oh, right. Okay. Right. I've got two derricks that I'd already set up. We're going to need a little bit of piping. And we'll just quickly set this up on camera. And then we will wrap this episode up there.
Don't get the piping there. We have piping down here.
Yes, we have the piping down the bottom, don't we? Okay, I'll grab
I'm so full of fuel blocks.
I know. But as we were pulling up the factories, any fuel blocks they had on them were obviously falling into our inventory. And when Shen removed the line containing the fuel blocks, he was also picking them up then as well.
Some of them had wood in them.
I know. We need to bring over some bricks. It needs to happen, Shen. We need more concrete slabs.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So badly. We must have the concrete slabs. Right, where's the nearest oil that we can Nab. Now there's some just down there from Ironton, which might be useful. Oh, there's a
yeah, I think the stuff in the east would be easy, yeah.
Oh my lord! I had this feeling. I'm looking at the map. I think I stopped near the tracks. I'd best check, because there's two trains pulling in. I must have been like a hair's breadth away from the train as it was passing me. I was too slow to have gone out of the way.
You don't even need me to die. You're just out there to kill yourself, aren't you?
I know, clearly. Hot. I needed the train to rush past.
So up here, there's some oil we can tap. And now this is something we're just going to pipe down because it's close and it's, I mean, we just want to pipe it down. But we do want to do some more exciting stuff with oil, including putting it into barrels and then onto trains. But that's going to be probably next time or maybe the next time. I don't know.
Yeah. That'll be
now watch it. I'm going to hold C. Watch out. Okay. No Aavak were harmed in the making of this episode. Oh, and also in the new update. Oh, God. You're going to get stone from these things. You can actually mine these rocks in the next update. Yeah.
I had no idea. There is a lot of new stuff coming in with the next update.
I see oil.
There we go. Now, hopefully.
I've got some lasers.
Good. Do you also have walls?
What's a wall?
Okay.
No, I do.
Thankfully, I do. Okay, good. I will leave you to set that up while I quickly make an underground pipe there. Donk. Actually, I already had a bunch. I don't know why I did that. I'm a fool. There we are.
I even can make a door.
Shen there you can go. With door.
I can has door.
What we'll do here is, for convenience, I'm going to use a substation. Now, this will show you just how enormous the substation range is. I think we've actually already covered them slightly with regards to the accumulators and the solar farms.
Right. But yeah, the nice thing about the substation is it just covers such a massive area.
Yeah.
The only downside is how many resources it uses. Wow.
Yeah, it does use an awful lot. Let's tidy this up a little bit. We don't need nearly this much room around here. So we'll pull it down a little bit. And this should protect this little area from any aggression. Oh, can you
pull
that all up? Thank you very much. There we go. And over we go. Perfect. Right, so this is fairly well protected, considering everything. Now,
I don't think we need this many lasers here.
No,
but
not at all. Eventually, this sort of thing would benefit from having a roboport, because then the roboport would allow it to be protected.
Repair.
Yes.
Yeah, we'll report here. A roboport here would A, allow bots to come and go. So if we wanted to, we could even have them take the oil barrels on the robots and have them bring them back to the base. That's possible. Yes. Or we could have the robots bring bullets out here and we could use regular old turrets. That would work as well. But the number one thing they'll do is if anything gets damaged by spitters or biters or whatever, the roboport will allow them to get repaired. And it's just such a huge advantage. It's like you don't have to run out and repair stuff when it gets damaged anymore.
Yep.
You still might have to, though.
Once you move to robots, a lot of new possibilities open to you.
Yeah, the game really changed with robots. Yeah. And it's easy to get lazy if you have lots of robots.
Yes, I was just about to cover that. They're almost a double-edged sword in that regard.
It's not necessarily a bad thing to get lazy with robots. It's just like the end game feel of the game is use robots for a lot of tasks. But I will say that I think it's a lot more fun to just use robots for some specific things and then keep doing what you've been doing, because really you don't need the robots to do everything for you, but they can if you want them to.
Yeah, exactly. It's one of the things, much like trains, for example, and how I've mentioned that quite often, I simply like using trains in the not even remotely efficient ways, but fun ways. I like making train tracks that have loops or passovers for the trains, and we wouldn't need the train for that. We could easily use a belt for it instead, but it's more fun to build a train network and having trains passing by each other and so on and so forth. Now, we have got plenty of oil coming through.
Are you saying that you play like Railroad Tycoon and Transport Tycoon Deluxe? I mean, are you sure?
Yeah, pretty much.
Are you sure you wanted to admit that those are in your genre tree?
100%. Okay. I enjoy streaming Transportation Tycoon. It is a good game. But there we go.
It's a lot of fun.
We've increased the oil income a little bit. We do need to do a lot more work to make this even remotely...
But hey, that's three more derricks. So if we check the oil tanks, are they actually filling up?
Yeah. They're not filling, but they are at least
they're not empty.
Empty, yeah.
Look, all of the refineries are turned on. They're on.
There we are.
Okay, we're good.
Kind of.
Well, that means we can build some lubricant, right?
Little peaks here and there.
We're gonna make some lubricant.
But we will have to be doing that in the next episode, I think.
Yeah.
This one is starting to run on a little bit. Do apologize about that, but would you like to take us out, Shen?
Well, I can hold down C and take you out again if you'd like.
I'd rather not. Sure, if I have an option.
Hope you guys enjoyed another episode of Factorio Beginner Series with Aavak and Shen. We'll see you next time. Take care, everyone. Thank you.